This week, Parliament granted the Bujiri Municipality MP Asman Basalira leave to table the Anti-Counterfeit Goods Bill. The bill proposes a tough sanction for individuals who manufacture counterfeit products in Uganda.
Madam Speaker, I beg to move a motion seeking leave of this August House to introduce a private member's bill entitled the Anti-Counterfeit Bill.
Not yet dealt into the merits and demerits, looking at the advantages and disadvantages, the provisions as proposed. But since the member is seeking leave of the House, it would be important that leave be granted such that we are able to see the content of what is seeking leave of the House to present as a private member's bill.
As I put a question that this House grants leave to Honorable Asman Basalira to introduce a private member's bill entitled the Anti-Counterfeit Bill. Those in favor say on the contrary, nay? The ayes have it.
In seeking leave of Parliament, Basalira argued that currently the enforcement mechanisms provided under intellectual property laws provide recourse to court in case of infringement and does not provide administrative remedies that can be accessed through national intellectual property agencies.
Uganda has no comprehensive law, a single comprehensive law on counterfeits. There are different pieces of this legislation that deal with the counterfeits in their narrow scope. But a single comprehensive law on counterfeit does not exist in Uganda. Now, because of that absence, there is even no law that broadly defines what counterfeiting is, what counterfeit goods are.
Basalira proposes that for someone who trades, sells and exposes counterfeit goods is liable to a fine not exceeding 5 times the value of the market price of the genuine goods, or imprisonment for a period not exceeding 5 years or both. For an individual who manufactures counterfeit products, the penalty is high, with Basalira proposing a fine not exceeding 20 times the value of the market price of the genuine goods, or imprisonment for a period not exceeding 7 years or both.
They are diverse, ranging from fines to imprisonment. But remember, this is a draft. What I have received today is leave to go and work on the draft bill. So we will have opportunity to engage different stakeholders that will provide different aspects and perspectives to the bill. And the stakeholders will come in, and I'm very sure that many aspects will be included or enriched in the bill.
Where goods are destroyed on the basis that they are perishable or detrimental to health or dangerous, and it is found upon inquiry that the goods were not counterfeit goods, the court shall order that reasonable compensation be paid to the owner or licensee of the goods. The bill also proposes to give a police officer powers to arrest without a warrant any person whom he or she suspects upon reasonable grounds of having committed any offense under this act, and may search and detain that person.
The enormity of the matter, assume a situation where you have counterfeit medicines and information has come to the attention of the police officer. If you don't arrest it at that level, then the damage on the public will be so huge. So that's why it's important that we create that latitude.
To what we know, the laws exist. It will be the question of strengthening the laws and implementation of the laws. The laws exist. So I think, but as of now, let's wait for him. When he brings what he has in mind, we compare it with the next of the laws, then we shall harmonize what is available. But me, in my opinion, I believe the laws do exist.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.